Hello everyone and wish you all a very happy new year. Last year taught us many things and GST also witnessed lots of changes. From today also many provisions, many rules of GST are being notified, like the most debatable one, rule 86B and also rule 36.4, also e-invoicing for taxpayers having turnover of more than 100 crores and so many other rules are being effective from today. But we are here not to talk about the laws, the provisions which has already been effected, which has already been enacted in GST law. Rather, we are here to discuss what we are expecting further from GST law. As we started with GST law, it was supposed to be a simple tax. But so far as I feel, and I think many of us feel, that is no more a simple tax. Yes, it can be simple for the entities, those who are dealing in multiple taxes, like those who are the manufacturing concern. Previously, they were dealing in service tax, excise, VAT and all these. So for them, it can be easy, it can be simpler in comparison to those, because now they are supposed to deal with only one department. Okay, and compliance is also only one compliance. Under one law, they are to do the compliance. But for what about those who were previously dealing with only one law, like you can say VAT, the organization which were involved only in trading, yeah, fir those organization whose goods were not taxable, or services were not taxable, but now after implementation of GST, their goods or services are also became taxable. So for them, I especially feel ki yes, GST is no more a simple tax with so many compliance burden and also so many frequent changes. So we have compiled some information and some points that we expect from GST law. We expect there should be certain changes in GST law down the line. Okay, so let's go through those points and the things that we expect ki bhi aane wale time mein GST mein ye sari changes honi chahiye.
It is certain that GST is no more a simple tax. But what are the reasons behind it becoming more and more complex? That is because of certain provisions that were added after GST was introduced, and we have although come in terms with almost all of them, but let's look at some of those changes which still require second thoughts. For example, in the recent notification number 94/2020, the registration process in GST, although it appeared that the process is being made more simpler owing to the fact that now biometric verification etc. will be done, but the time limits have actually been extended from 3 days to 7 days, 21 days to 30 days. So the ease of doing business, although CBIC is saying is not going to be affected, but yes, when the GST registration itself is going to take so much time, then definitely we cannot call it a simple process. The next one is the GST amnesty scheme. Most professionals and businessmen have been asking for extending this GST amnesty scheme, especially owing to the fact that the entire year 2020 went by during lockdown, etc. So we can say that businesses were hampered, compliances became secondary. So a lot of taxpayers, a lot of businessmen really need this amnesty scheme so that they can pay off their tax dues. The next one is something which has come into highlight now. The reason being that after around 3.5 years of GST implementation, we have found out that the refund process, although it was made in such a manner so as to process refunds swiftly so that every taxpayer who deserves a refund gets it in stipulated time period. But if we note carefully, the provision of refund is such that every time a deficiency memo is issued by the department, an application which is rectifying that particular deficiency memo by the taxpayer would be considered as a fresh application. So this is a big hardship for the taxpayers, considering the fact that relevant date is only 2 years from the required date, whatever the date may be, based on different situations, like it is different in case of export with payment of tax and all other cases, for example, when we are making payment in cash ledger, etc., etc. So yes, the relevant date is 2 years, and if within 2 years we get the deficiency memo, but fresh application is filed after that, then it will be a big hardship for the taxpayers if that would be considered as time barred and the period of limitation would apply on it. So the government definitely must think over this so that the first application that is made within the period of 2 years should be considered. The last date to claim ITC for financial year 1920. So yesterday, rather 30th December, we had submitted a letter to the Ministry of Finance asking for an extension to claim ITC pertaining to financial year 1920, since the last date to claim this particular ITC was the return for the month of September 2020, which was 20th or 22nd or 24th October, as the case may be. But then the problem is that April, May, June 2020, these 3 months literally had almost no business for most businessmen and for most taxpayers. So of course, when business was halted, compliances were a long forgotten thing. So yes, a lot of taxpayers, a lot of businessmen had actually not been able to reconcile the ITC which they had claimed. So accordingly, there may be a lot who have simply missed it. Also, not just 1920, ITC must be allowed to be claimed till the time GST audit is conducted, because any mismatch or any difference is actually identified only at the time of GST audit. So that is also one thing which the government must consider. The new return forms. When GST was introduced, we had three returns: GSTR 1, 2 and 3, monthly returns. Well, they were never implemented at all. Yes, we are filing GSTR 1 and GSTR 3B. Later, the new return forms RET 1, RET 2, etc. came, but they also have not been implemented. Because of this, Rule 86B, Rule 36.4 and all provisions of these kinds have to be brought in so as to ensure that there is no loss from the revenues point of view. But what about the taxpayers? The system should be implemented in such a manner that the system itself is doing all the reconciliation and calculation, which was the thought when GSTR 1, 2 and 3 were introduced in the GST law. They were not implemented, that's a different matter altogether. But the government must think about something so that the entire returns that we are submitting does the reconciliation there and there. Because the small businessmen, they may suffer huge losses because of these complex calculations and complexities involved. Revision of returns. Like we started this video, like we said earlier, GST is no longer a simple tax. Yes, regular changes, regular introduction of different provisions, etc., have made it more and more complex, not just for taxpayers, but also for professionals. Owing to these complexities, the provision for revision of returns must be introduced, because at present, all we can do is amend certain invoices in our GSTR 1. Yes, we can cumulatively correct R3B, but that exactly is not revision of returns. Just the way we had a provision for revision of returns in the earlier regime, just the way we have the provision of revision of returns in income tax, similarly, we must have a provision to revise the GST returns as well. When we are introducing a new law, when we are working on a new law, then the good parts of all the other laws must definitely be considered so as to ensure that the new law is also absolutely perfect. So yes, although a law cannot really be perfect, but still this is one simple thing which can be introduced by the government very easily so as to ensure that the taxpayers can revise their returns wherein they have made certain mistakes. So that was all about what we feel are the changes which GST must definitely face or witness. But yes, if you have certain changes or if you have certain other expectations from this year in the GST law, then feel free to comment your suggestions in the comment section below. And if you have not subscribed to our channel yet, then do subscribe with us to stay connected for all the further updates. Thank you.